I get this ability and feeling to create. And in doing so, in creating whatever you create, there's an energy and a passion. And it just makes you feel much more alive, much more focused. And for me, art is about creating and just developing something out of nothing. And then seeing the reaction that it produces, it's just priceless.
It is basically a journey, and I've never done much art before in my life, and it's very relaxing.
Art in general is a creativity of oneself. The ability to know that you yourself have these abilities that are hidden inside of you.
Everyone's got a different technique and a different story to tell. So it really is a treat. It's a treat.
I'm Anne Hall. Welcome to Mature Living, a program that features topics of interest for older adults. On today's show, we'll explore art and its special significance to older adults. Joining me for the first part of today's discussion is Gay Hanna, Executive Director of the National Center for Creative Aging, Julie Ellis, Director of the Holland Hall Senior Center for Creative Retirement, and Art Beat columnist for the county's Golden Gazette. And Irene Rouse, a senior artist. Welcome to all of you.
Thank you.
Gay, let's start with you. There's a new concept called creative aging. So how does this differ from the former understanding of aging? And what's happening in this new field?
It's very exciting. You know, we have 30 extra years to live. In the 1900s, people lived to just about 45. And by the turn of the 21st century, we were living, and we are living, past 80 as a regular thing. So there's lots of time to explore the arts, and we're seeing a great growth in participation in music, dance, literature, and as you can see around us, the wonderful work of painting. Yes. So it is looking at aging in terms of potential, rather than a time of loss and decline.
Mm-hmm. It's very promising. Dr. Gene Cohen was an American psychiatrist, and he was a pioneer in researching late life development. Could you tell us a little bit about his contributions and how that may relate to what we were just talking about?
Absolutely. Dr. Cohen was really one of the key founders of the field of creative aging. He wrote The Creative Age at the turn of the century and The Mature Mind in 2006, where he talked about, contrary to popular belief, our brains keep growing. And making art, Dr. Cohen would say, is like chocolate for your brain. It just massages your brain because your brain is active, your synapses are connecting, and the arts engage every part of your being. So it's very positive.
Isn't that great? Could you tell us more about your organization and a little bit about the history and the mission of your organization?
Yes. Well, we are dedicated to promoting creative expression in all of its forms as healthy to the aging process, just by the fact that it does stimulate your brain, it engages your whole body and being. We came here in 2007 from Brooklyn, New York, actually to join Dr. Cohen, who at that time was directing a center at George Washington University. Now we have close to 5,000 members, mostly professionals like Julie, who are looking to our center to learn new ways to engage older people in the arts. And we also are working with doctors and nurses, healthcare practitioners, long-term care providers who also want to improve the quality of life of older people, no matter where you live or what stage of life mm-hmm. you are finding yourself.
Very good. So you mentioned that art can be very helpful to people as they age. Can you talk a little bit more about how it contributes to the well-being of seniors?
Well, Dr. Cohen said that it contributed in two ways. First, it keeps you learning. So he found that as long as we're engaged in learning, he called it mastering new things, our brains would thrive and grow. Then the second thing the arts do is they enable people to be highly socially engaged. And that, of course, counters some of the things that are real problems with aging, and that is being isolated, mm-hmm. being depressed because you're no longer at your job. Your whole identity has changed.
Right.
Being involved in creative expression really gives you back your unique identity, and that's the power of it.
Isn't that interesting? Gay, I understand that some famous artists, like William de Kooning, for example, continued producing art even after they were diagnosed with dementia. Can you tell us more about the impact of art on adults with dementia?
Yes, I tell you, it's so encouraging in a very tough place. Mm-hmm. As we grow old in masses, 10,000 baby boomers hit 65 each and every day, there's going to be more people that have Alzheimer's and dementia. Mm-hmm. What we find is the arts are so deep within us that often when other modes of communication have left our abilities, the arts still allow us to communicate. De Kooning kept painting. I have stories of people that could continue to sing with their loved ones mm. because the power of music is so deep within our brains. I've heard stories of people that couldn't carry on a conversation being able to quote their favorite poem. So again, it's quality of life for all. With people with dementia, it allows us all to be in the moment with them and let them expand their imagination while their memory is not expanding.
Isn't that wonderful? Well, Julie, as a director of a county senior center, I'm sure you've seen some of this in action. And you yourself are an artist, right?
Oh,
I understand you come from a...
pretty much. I don't use that label that often because I'm a little bit modest about what I do when I have time.
Well, you come from a family of artists. I understand.
Pretty much. Again, they probably wouldn't refer to themselves as artists, but my brother painted. He's a mm-hmm. photographer. My sister actually studied weaving in Finland and is a graphic artist. She worked for Vera. My father, as well, when he aged, took some art classes at adult education, and I took some classes with him, which was just a wonderful time to bond a little bit more with him. Mm-hmm. Similar to Irene's paintings here, he basically took the colors right out of the tube. So they were vibrant and alive and just wonderful. And it was a great experience for him. And my mom was an artist and a guitarist in her younger years.
Mm-hmm. So have you discovered anything about your relationship with art changing as you get older?
That it's definitely going to be more part of my life mm-hmm. as I get older. Still trying to figure out what my medium is. I do mostly, like Irene, acrylic mm-hmm. painting. I love mermaids, so my theme is usually a mermaid surrounded by water and whatever environment. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty much realizing that art is an essential part of your life as you age. And working at a senior center, I saw the need for more programs and to bring people in to not necessarily learn about art per se in terms of painting, mm-hmm. but just creativity and to kind of look at themselves and those old messages that they learned as a child and try to understand those and maybe make those changes that creativity can be learned.
Exactly. You've been featuring art in your center's programming for some time now. Could you please tell us a bit about the types of art programs that you offer and how the participants at your center have responded to these programs?
Well, I think when I first got there, I've been there about 13 years, there were some basic art classes, not many, and my belief was that art and creativity needed to be part of an older adult's life, whether they did it in their youth or not. It had to be offered. So we have more classes that we've established over the last few years, watercolor classes, acrylic classes. I teach a class on creativity using Michael Gelb's book, How to Think Like Leonardo da Vinci. And then we have a play lab where we experiment with different mediums.
That sounds wonderful. Irene, we haven't forgotten about you. We've been enjoying your beautiful artwork here.
Thank you.
I have to ask you, are you a new artist?
I started about 15 years ago. I was just telling a story about how my mother had told me once that to not develop a talent was a sin. She made it quite scary. And so one day I was getting to be 70 and I thought, my goodness, I haven't done anything with my art because I was more focused on poetry and writing. So then fortuitously a friend asked me to come to the Eastern Shore Art League meeting, and so then I went out and got some paints. So it's been about 15 years.
So you've been painting for 15 years?
Just
That's
about.
Wonderful. So tell me about your art. What do you like to, what's your favorite type of painting to create?
I veer around from one thing to another, landscape. Mm-hmm. I like to paint houses and row houses and scenes like that. And in this one painting over there, I branched out to do the little children at the daycare center next door. So, I do a little bit of everything.
So what do you get out of art personally? What has it given you?
It's just one word, joy. Mm-hmm. And the feeling that I am still able to use my brain and my creativity. And Julie's class in creativity is a good one too.
Mm-hmm. I bet. Yeah. Has it affected the way you look at the world?
I think I see more things now. I see mm-hmm. colors and just the drive from my house to the center, I will see something that I might not have noticed before, mm-hmm. how trees do and flowers.
Thank you all for joining us. It's been a pleasure to have you here today and to hear about all the wonderful things that you're doing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Stay tuned to Mature Living. In our next segment, we'll learn about a community art project in McLean, and then how art programming is used to help participants with dementia in the county's adult day healthcare centers.
Do a couple together. You go up and down, up. Like a stamp. Yeah.
It's a beginning of my happiness.
May, that's perfect. Here, and see what color you think would be a good base color. So you can do something dark.
The colors can be on top.
That looks so good.
Doing this as, I've done a lot of it, but every time I do one of these or I play a game, etc., I feel I'm in better shape.
So to get started, let's pick a color that you think will go well on top of this color. So you have yellow, you have a darker green.
That's looking great.
I like flowers and buildings. Coming here takes up my time because I wouldn't have anything else to do but sit and watch television. Well, you can't have too many other thoughts in your head when you're doing artwork.
Joining us for the second part of today's discussion is Sharon Fischel, Outreach Director for the McLean Project for the Arts, and Kimberly Warner, a recreational therapist at the Mount Vernon Adult Day Healthcare Center. Sharon, tell us about the McLean Project for the Arts. I understand that you have art programming for all ages and that you also have a gallery.
That's right. We are the oldest alternative art space in Northern Virginia. We were founded in 62, and we service large groups in the community, including Fairfax County school students, as well as seniors. Our mission is to exhibit contemporary art to audiences that include both contemporary known artists and up-and-coming artists.
That's very interesting. Now, you mentioned art programming. Mm-hmm. What kind of programming do you offer for older adults?
We have a very special program called the Outreach Program for Seniors, mm-hmm. which was begun in 2009. One of our board members at the time, Ed Shaheen, was the brainchild who came to me and asked that we create a program for seniors, and we have been happily engaged with many community centers in senior populations since.
Mm-hmm. And what are some of the classes that you offer for seniors? What are their activities?
Well, I am the director and I'm also an artist myself, so I do a lot of outreach to various centers, including the Lewinsville Senior Center, the James Lee Community Center, Pimmit Hills. I go with art supplies, and we do painting, drawing, and collage. We also talk about contemporary art history. And many of these seniors have a lot to say about what we're doing and also what we're looking at. We look at a lot of pictures mm-hmm. as well as making art. Mm-hmm.
So what do you say to people who tell you that they aren't creative?
That's a wonderful question.
Okay.
I don't think about our programming in terms of creativity. I think about it in terms of materials that are given as a physical experience and a mentally stimulating experience, which enables seniors to respond to the things that they're looking at. So often I'll bring still life objects that are very familiar, including live flowers, fruits, different objects, and the seniors will draw and paint them because they're familiar with them. They get to touch them and they have a creative experience because they're responding to those things. Mm-hmm. So even if someone feels as though they're not creative, that doesn't really enter into the dialogue because they're responding in a very natural way. So it isn't really about creativity, it's about responding to something.
So what kinds of interactions do you observe as seniors take these classes and actually create art? Do you notice a difference
of
tone in the class?
Absolutely, and we are recording those responses in many different ways. We ask people in the beginning what they're thinking about, and towards the end of the year, we actually, in two senior centers, we gave bi-monthly classes. So we have a lot of in-depth experience with seniors starting often with drawing. Mm-hmm. And then I'm a painter, so I encourage a lot of painting. And collage is a wonderful experience because you don't always have to know what it is you're going to do mm-hmm. when you're doing it. And it's very freeing for the mind.
That's lovely. Well, Kimberly, you work with participants at the county's adult day health care centers, right? And you mentioned there were five of these centers.
That's right.
Can you tell us a bit more about the centers and the participants who yes. are at these centers?
We take them as early as 18 years or older, mm-hmm. and with physical or cognitive impairments, and they require supervision at home, so they come to the center. And we also include all types of dementia as well.
Interesting.
And we provide a therapeutic recreation program that stimulates their quality of life or maintains what they still have mm-hmm. through adaptive sports, mm-hmm. fitness, art therapy, aromatherapy, reminiscing, and there's just a few activities that we do.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now, you mentioned art therapy. How does art therapy differ from art?
Art therapy is a process mm-hmm. of beginning, middle, and end, and it's really having them understand the whole concept. Like, what's the goal? Mm-hmm. What's the purpose? Mm-hmm. And it's really the journey, not the destination of how did we get here? And what did I accomplish? And that's what we do with them at the center. And art to me is, I'm here to create a product or a painting, but it's not going through all those steps.
Interesting. So could you explain to us how you use art therapy? And in your programming, you mentioned that you do offer courses for, or you offer exposure for people with dementia.
Yes, we do.
If you could speak to that a little bit.
Sure. We usually do art therapy in a group of 4 to 6 participants, mm-hmm. and we have a goal in mind and our assignment. And they really benefit for the socialization piece. Usually everybody's doing it for the first time. Everybody's on the same page. They feel comfortable with one another, and it really increases their self-esteem, their self-awareness, a positive environment, and it's very rewarding to them. And with some of our participants with mild to moderate word loss, they're not able to speak mm-hmm. as much, but you can see it through their art. Mm. Through their expressions or paintings. So it's really neat to see them come alive and really let us know what they accomplished.
That's wonderful. Yeah. So are many of these people new to the art experience, or have some of these people been painters or creators in the past?
That's a very good question. I think it's half and half. Mm-hmm. I think half of them are painters, have done a little art in their lives. Others are just been working so much work, and it's really interesting to see how those individuals who worked so much had been given the opportunity to use the art. They come alive. Wow, I can really do this with one hand versus two. But it's just amazing that they're reborn, like they're given a purpose, mm-hmm. and it for those people who've done art, it really gives them a new sense of, how can I brush up? How have I changed through my art? How can I make it stronger?
How can people learn about these programs or enroll in some of these programs?
Some of the adult day healthcare centers have an art therapist that come in, mm-hmm. and it's also using the resources to see if we can get volunteers to come in to help us. But usually, staff and I usually run the programs.
Sharon and Kim, this is such beneficial work. How has it affected you as a person working with seniors and seeing them involved in the artistic process? How has it affected you at MPA?
I am very excited about the potential that I've experienced working with many levels of seniors who are under the Senior Plus program, seniors who are just registered for art classes, because there's a wealth of information that they, as a participant in the ArtReach program, have to offer that is extremely enriching about their lives, about their thoughts about very contemporary art. So I've learned things from them as individuals that is very compelling to me. Mm-hmm. And also we work with many different levels, including a lot of children. So this is a very different audience for us, and it is more and more important that we reach out to as many groups as we can, because they have so much to give us as an organization.
Interesting. And how about you, Kimberly?
With working with them, with art therapy, it really has made me get closer to them, to understand their way of thinking, how they process a piece of art. It really has given me more of an insight of what they like to do. So mm-hmm. when I program things, I would like to do this differently, or I would like to do this. So it really gives me a better understanding of what they would like to do, and where they would like to go and grow. Because there's so many different avenues of art therapy. And with getting to know them better, you can see their self-esteem come alive, their assurance of, wow, I can really do this. And that's the aha moment of like, wow, I really got through to them, or we got through to them. And it really, that's why I do it, because it's something new, exciting that we can offer to them. And so they can enjoy it, because they're seniors, and we want to stimulate them as long as they can go. And that's my goal. And you can really see it through their artwork.
Wonderful. Well, thank you both of you for joining us today and for describing these programs that are so beneficial to our senior community. And thank you, our viewing audience, for watching this edition of Mature Living. I'm Ann Hall, and we'll see you next time